Welcome back to a brand new coffee tech break with Jan. Good to see you back again on my channel. I think I got another great video for you lined up because I want to take you through the PolySync family. And so in one of my other videos, I took you through the hardware, buttons, the settings, the cable lengths, etc. In this coffee tech break today, I want to take you through the configuration settings using the PolyLens app. And so we got the Lens app, which runs on Mac, runs on the Windows PC, but also you're able to configure the settings from the PolyLens in the cloud. So today, I want to take you through all those options available. And I will do that for the Sync 40. So this is the Sync 40, which I also showed you in my earlier video, and I'll put a link up there so you're able to find that quickly. This is the Sync 20, which is your personal device, and it comes in a very nice package. So 20 is a little bit smaller, got three microphones inside there. Then we got the 40, it's this one. So the 40 is a little bit bigger, and also the difference with the 40 is that you got the 360 lightning around it. So let me show you that. So here you see on both sides of a 40, you have that lightning. So in case you put the volume up and down, you see that on both sides, the volume with the LED light will be going up and down. Same with the 60. So 60 also has that 360 LED lightning arounding. Also the 40 has three microphones inside, and the 60 has six microphones inside, really for those mid to larger rooms. And I showed you that in my earlier video. So if you wanna know some more about different hardware options with the 20, 40, and 60, I recommend to look at that other video. Now, what I wanted to do today is on my laptop, wanted to take you through all those different settings you have with those devices, because I think it's really great, but you need to find the Lens app. You need to find your way in the Lens cloud to configure some different settings. And this is what I wanted to take you through today. So as usual, I will jump in my laptop now and show you all those different settings. Let's go. Take a cup of coffee, sit back, relax, and let me walk you through the Lens app, as there has been quite some development in the last year. So at the end, the Lens application will replace the PLT Hub, the Plantronics Hub software. Lens app is that new application. Now, I will put a link in the comments where you're able to find the Windows version or the Mac version to install it standalone. And similar we had with the PLT Hub, Plantronics Hub, that standalone installation with similar application. If you got one or two headsets, if you got just a Sync series at home and you just want to be able to upgrade software, you can install the standalone application. In case you got an IT administrator who wanted to manage all the devices from the cloud, be able to export logs, inventory, etc., then you should be able to receive an invitation from that IT administrator. So he sent you an invitation. If you then install it from that invitation, it will automatically register itself to the cloud service at the Lens cloud. So all your devices, which I see here, will automatically also pop up in Lens in the cloud. Now, what do you have here? So let me give you a walkthrough of the software, because there's quite some things happening with this Lens application. First off, the insights. So on the insights, there's also some things happening. First off, you got a usage report, which is upcoming. It's still in a sort of sandbox, but there's a lot of functionality which they want to put on the inside. So as a user, I'm able to see the usage report during the week, etc. Network diagnostic testing. So you could run some tests here. If I click on that, it will test your network and it's able to fulfill audio and video information. So you're able to provide that feedback and create a screenshot and provide this feedback back to your IT administrator. And I also can imagine that your IT administrator is able to initiate this remotely. And so in case you want to run some tests on your network, they're able to do that also with this client. Initiate that from the Lens Cloud just to check if you got video issues, headset, audio issues, etc. Always able to run those tests here. Now, that is the first off, right? That is the insights. Wellness and wealth is also a big one. There's also been quite some additionals here. Soundscaping. Soundscaping is probably something you know from Plantronics, and where their soundscaping was very important in the environment. So to inject some of those nature sounds to provide some rest in that environment. So if I enable that, you can create a sort of atmosphere like mountain range, gentle ocean. So you can have all sort of sounds injected in your environment, which creates a sort of very stable and relaxed environment to work in. Some other one, Emily Brook, very nice and relaxed sounds. And there's a lot of people who can concentrate very well with this sound injected. So you have that available, that soundscaping is available in the Lens application. Also, you can inject some health and wellness organization. So if you wanna be able to drink water once an hour, you wanna get reminders of that, you can also do that. And so there's a lot of nice things built into this client, which can help you. And also, if you got some vision breaks, so after half an hour, just look outside and make sure your eyes get some rest. So there's a lot of nice things which they built into this app. That is the wellness and health best practices. Very nicely to give you some guidance on the headband adjustments, boom placements, but also for the camera placement, mounting options, and the lighting, of course, very important when you have also meetings at home, of course, workstation setup. So it gives you just some regular guidance on best practices with your own environment. Then we got Poly support. And so here you see that it's hooked up to my tenant, for example. The IT administrator is able to see that very quickly. So also in that Lens in the cloud, you can see that tenant, which is able to compare very easily if you hooked up to the right tenant. As you see here, the tenant ID. You see also the software version, etc. I can also download logs here. So in case needed for support, we can provide that. That's all available in the basis here on the Poly Lens app. Now, then we got here on the right side, we got some additional settings. And so we got the account settings. On the general settings, we have, for example, launch the application automatically at startup. So this is also very nice to make sure the application starts if you reboot, or in case you have to do some updates and you restart the computer, it's always able to launch the client. Soft phone, so which soft phones you wanna let your devices respond to. And so you're also able to configure them here. Notification alerts, this can be, for example, if your device is disconnected or out of battery or unpaired. So you can enable all those things right here in the client. Then we got the languages, which you can select. Software updates, very important. Make sure you're always on that latest version. As I said, the Lens app is going through a lot of developments and updates, supporting all the latest and greatest. So this is automatically being done, checking for that version if you click here on the software updates. And the about is just some license information. Now, all the way below, you got the restore defaults. So in case you got some issues or your device is not detected or something, if you click on restore defaults, you will get back into the login screen and you're going through that initial setup wizard very, very easily. Now, that is the Lens application. If you then hook up different devices, they will show up right here. So here you can just go through those different devices and configure them. So for example, I click now here on the Sync 60. And what you will see is on the right side, it will give you now an overview of the device. Not only the battery and that it is connected, but also it will check the software updates. So I can easily click on update and make sure the device has that latest update available. Now, if you click on that number, you see right here, it will redirect you to the Poly support website, as you can see here. And it will give you information on the latest and greatest. So as you will see for the Sync 60, we just got a brand new release for this month, and it's now able to work with Zoom Rooms. It's officially, Sync 60 is officially certified for Zoom Rooms. So you're able to hook that up also now to those devices and also resolved issues. So apparently there was some confusing in the naming for the mute and unmute, which has been resolved, and some other minor bugs. Now let me walk you through the settings of the Sync 60. And these are identical for the Sync 40 and for the Sync 20. The only settings you miss with the Sync 20 are, for example, the daisy chain settings. And so with the Sync 40, as I showed you in one of the other videos, the Sync 40, you can daisy chain that easily to another Sync 40, to extend that in the room, which I think is a really nice option. If you got that flexible meeting room, you need another speaker a little bit further in the room, you're able to extend the 40 very flexible. And similar with the Sync 60, you can also extend that very easily to another Sync 60. These are the additional settings you have. Now, if you make any changes here in the Lens app, it will happen on the fly. So there's not something like a save button here. If you change something, it will just happen right there. It's using Bluetooth, if you got it connected using that dongle, the BT600 or BT700, or if you got it connected over USB to the laptop. Languages here. So here you got your voice prompts, which you can change and change it to different languages if you want that. So that is available. Select languages for also, for example, volume, maximum volume, mute. You can change it to all different voice prompts or audio sounds, depending on how you want to configure it. But here you can set the languages for all those different audio alerts. Under general settings, we got second incoming call. So for example, my Sync 40 here is connected using the USB cable here to the laptop. Now, if it sits on the other end connected using Bluetooth to the mobile phone, if then a call comes in on the mobile phone and I have a call, a Zoom call using the USB cable, it will ring once. And what you will see, it can ignore it if you don't want to have any audio sound, or you can ring continuously to make sure that at the end, and you probably want to pick up your mobile phone. Now, then we got mute alerts, also very nice. So you hear a feedback when you press that mute button. And so as soon as you do that, you usually hear that sound. If you mute it and you unmute it, then you got that audio sound. Now you have that available as a single tone, but you can also configure that as a double tone, or you can even configure a voice so that it will mute, so the device is muted. And so you can configure this here to your own needs. Now, then we got notification tone. So this is when other devices are connected and while streaming audio. We got connection indication. So as soon as your Bluetooth is connected, as soon as your USB connected, anything is connected, it will give you a voice prompt. So that will be presented in the languages and you can configure it in the top. Then we got the rocket button, the famous rocket button now, which is on every device. It's hidden here behind that that sticker when you receive it. So you can configure that rocket button to your own needs. You can clear the trusted device list. That means the devices which are Bluetooth connected. If you press that button there, you can press it to hold and resume a call. So let's say you are on Zoom and you want to hold or resume, and you just press that rocket button and you're able to use it that way. Or if you play music, and you can pause the music or play. If you're connected over Bluetooth with your mobile phone, you can do a redial. You can set it to a status check. So that means if the Bluetooth is connected, is the battery still full, you can do that check. So you can configure that really to your own needs, that rocket button. And also, if you got Siri or Google Assistant, you're also able to set that right here. Very nice. So that is that rocket button, which I showed you earlier. Here we got the daisy chain audio. So if you got two of those Sync 40s in front of you, you want to put them in stereo mode, you can use them and configure them right here in that stereo mode. So that means you really got that right and that left configured in your meeting room or in your home office. I think a really, really nice feature. Now, if you want to just have a single speaker, you can put it into party mode. And that means it's one single speaker on the table. So just depending how you want to configure it. Then we got the equalizer. So if you want to add some additional lower level audios, you can have the bass. As the Sync 20, the 1460, they have a bass reflex port there. So it's very nice, especially if you want to play some music. I would keep it to bass. If you want to have flat or bright audio, and you can change that also right here. Then we can set the ringtones and volume. So this is identical, and to program the mute button here, you can configure the volume control. So that means you will have a sound when you get to the maximum, or you will have a sound at every level. So if you press that volume button up and down, you can have a sound at every level, or just have a sound only at the minimum and the maximum. So here you can configure that. Play a ringtone when a device doesn't have a ringtone. So you can also turn that off. So when there's an incoming call, volume, min and max alerts. So if you reach that maximum of the volume control, you can give it a tone or also give it a voice prompt. So here you can see, you can really customize this to your own needs. Do you want to have really that voice prompt, or just looking for a small confirmation with the audio sound? You can configure that right here. Looking at soft phones. So here you can configure to hear dial tone when you're using, for example, a voice over IP call. You can also enable that right here. For wireless, there's also quite some options. So you got HD voice that will take some additional and consume some additional power, but will give you that HD audio quality with those speakers. Under wireless, we also have here two very interesting settings. One of them is the exclusive connection. If you turn that one on, only one Bluetooth device can be connected at the same time. So if I pair my mobile phone to the device, I can use it. Now, if another person pairs it, it will automatically forget my device. So there's only one device can be connected to the Sync family. Very interesting, which we see a lot, of course, in the corporate environments, where you want to have only one device connected probably to the device. So it's not that somebody is walking away out of the meeting room and the device can still be connected. That's a similar feature with the secure Bluetooth connection. What does that mean? That when you Bluetooth pair a mobile phone and you do your call, as soon as the call is finished, it will ask you if the call is really finished and do you want to forget the Bluetooth device automatically. If you want to keep the connection with Bluetooth, you just press one of the buttons. So this is also a very interesting settings. And this also comes from the fact that when people Bluetooth pair it with the speaker, and they walk out of the room and maybe they sit somewhere else and a call comes in, it will ring in that room because the device was still connected. And so we got really some interesting settings here available, which I would just recommend and to test your most optimal setting for your environment, just to make sure that that gives the best user experience. But especially the secure Bluetooth connection is also an interesting because it just gets the device. So if you don't press anything, you finished your call, you walk out of the room, it will automatically forget your mobile phone connection. So really, really great settings to use in corporate. And lastly, we got restore defaults. So here you can set your device with all the default factory settings when you want to change everything back. This is all inside the Sync 60 configuration settings, and this can be done locally. Now, we also have the sync in the cloud. So in case you hook your local sync app, you hook that up with the sync in the cloud, you will also have the settings right here. Now, you can go to inventory, then you can go and search for the Lens desktop client. As you see here, this is my Lens desktop client. You can find serial numbers, IPs, MAC addresses, etc. Also the version. You can see that my Lens desktop client is online. Now I can click on that, and then you will find all the devices which are connected to my Lens desktop app. As you can see here, very, very nice. Now you can easily click on a device, for example, the Sync 60, and here you will find all the information you can find and see if there's any software updates available. Now I can also click here on the settings, and under settings you will find similar settings as we've just seen in the Lens app locally at the user. So if you got standalone edition, you can configure that locally. If you want to force some policies from the Lens in the cloud, you can do that right here. So you will find here similar settings for the volume, for the different dial tone settings, also the wireless options. You can find them right here, also to reset the device. So similar settings as you've seen on the Lens desktop app. You'll find them here in the Lens cloud. Here ends the video on the Sync family to walk you through all the different settings. Hopefully you enjoyed it and you got now some good insights of all the possibilities with the Lens app or when using Lens in the cloud. Now, if you like this type of video, again, I recommend to subscribe to my channel, and I will give you a sign when I got some new videos uploaded. Thank you for watching, and I'm already looking forward to the next video.